إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين.
إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بين يدي الساعة بشيرًا ونذيرًا، فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف عنها الغمة وتركها على محجة بيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصل اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Respected brothers and sisters, continuing on with the series of similitudes and examples from the Sunnah, we started with the hadith of Ibn Umar and the similitude between the date palm tree and a believer. And we mentioned in the previous khutbah few aspects of similarity between the believer and the tree. And today we will continue. One of the points is the soil. Just like a date palm tree does not grow in just any soil, and it has to be a good soil for it to grow, let alone to produce. You can attempt in a bad soil and the tree will not grow. In some soils it'll grow, but it won't produce. And in other soils it'll grow and produce, but very poorly. So it has to be a good soil in order to grow and produce. And likewise, in the case of the believer, not any heart can hold faith. It has to be a heart that is guided by Allah and deserving to be guided. When Allah Azza wa Jal warned the believers from reaching the state of being hard-hearted, not submissive when Allah is mentioned, or by means of neglecting the mention of Allah Azza wa Jal, he said after that, اعلموا أن الله يحيي الأرض بعد موتها. Know that Allah is the one who gives life to the earth after its lifelessness. This is an indication that just as Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who makes this earth, this soil, lifeless, does not produce, so not every palm tree, not every soil can grow palm trees. Likewise, it is Allah who puts life in the hearts, and thus the heart is able to be guided and hold faith. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, the resemblance between the soil and the heart is that the soil is the place that holds the water and thus is a means of growing the tree and its products. And the heart is the place that holds faith and thus produces its fruits in the forms of good actions and words. Another point is maintenance and removing harmful effects. It's very normal that weeds and wild plants grow around trees. And therefore, if a date palm tree is not maintained well, continuously by removing these harmful plants and weeds from around it, it will weaken the process of growth and thus affect the product. Likewise, as the believer, as we go on in life, we encounter different situations and different matters that harm our faith, have bad impacts on our faith. So how do we maintain that? A believer should cleanse his heart by holding himself to account regularly, by removing any effect, any harmful effect on the heart. The whispers of shaitan, desires, temptations, the whispers of our inner souls. Strive hard for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal to cleanse your heart so it becomes deserving of guidance. As Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. And those who strive for our sake, we will surely guide them to our path. The path of guidance, the path of pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the path of piety. The next point is a point that's taken from one of the narrations of the hadith mentioned in the first khutbah, in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described the date palm tree as tu'ti ukulaha kulla hin. It produces its fruits at all times, so it is continuous in fruits. Ibn Jarir rahmatullahi alayhi said, there is no doubt that a believer produces fruits in the form of deeds, words and actions that are raised to Allah Azza wa Jal daily. He said, we're not saying yearly or every 6 months or every 2 months, daily. And in this he's referring to the narration that is in Bukhari and Muslim, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam informs us that there are angels who descend at Asr time, that's their shift from Asr until Fajr, to record the deeds of the son of Adam. And then at the time of dawn, they ascend, and the people for the morning, the angels rather for the morning, ascend and take their place and start recording the deeds. He said, he will not fail, a believer will not fail having a good deed raised, being raised to Allah, a fruit of his deeds being raised to Allah Azza wa Jal daily. Then he said, but one might ask, how can this be similar to a date palm tree when it only produces its dates during the summer? He said, yes indeed, but during the winter it produces the heart palm. You know, it's at the top where the crown of the tree is. That's where the heart of the palm is, and it's edible. Another thing taken from the date palm tree is the date palm pollen. It's consumed and it's used as a dietary supplement. So the fruits of the tree is continuous, and the fruits of the believer is also continuous, day and night. Next point is, again, one of the narrations which is in Sahih Muslim. The previous one and the point before it is in Sahih Ibn Hibban, and the Albani class it as authentic. This one is in Sahih Muslim. He said, among the trees is a tree that's blessed just like a Muslim. It's blessed, it's beneficial. There are benefits in every part of the palm tree. Just like a believer has benefit in every aspect in him. His words benefit people. His actions benefit people. His behavior and conduct benefit people. His appearance benefit people. He's beneficial to those who are related to him. His parents, his children, his wife, his all kinship. And he's also beneficial to those who are not related to him. His neighbors, his colleagues, his classmates, his guests, the Muslims at large. He feels for them. He suffers for their suffering and thus strives hard to support them. Ibn Hajar said that a date palm tree is blessed and beneficial in all its parts from the time it starts growing until it dries out and dies. And then he started enumerating the things that people benefit from it, like dates, like the sheets and the dry leaves, right? He said even the seed of the date is used, wax is extracted, oil is taken from it, that's in its life. And he said that after it dries out and dies, the trunk is used as wood, the sheets are used to make baskets, chairs, ceilings, so on and so forth. He said, and likewise as a believer, even after his death, people benefit from him. They benefit from knowledge he spread. They benefit from wealth he left behind in the form of a continuous charity. They benefit from righteous children he raised properly and thus become productive elements in the community. And his ears benefit from his own wealth that he leaves behind for them. So there is a barakah. There is a benefit and a blessing in every aspect of the believer, just like there is a barakah and a benefit in every part of the date palm tree. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه. ثم أما بعد، in one of the narrations that is in the book of Imam Bukhari, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when he was given the similitude of the date palm tree in a believer, he said, it is, referring to the date palm tree, evergreen, and it does not lose its leaves. Ibn al-Qayyim said a beautiful statement commenting on this narration. He said, just as the date palm tree does not lose or take off its adornment in the form of its green leaves. A believer never takes off the garment of taqwa. He's always keen to be wearing this garment of piety, and thus resembles the date palm tree in its adornment and being evergreen and beautiful. Another form of similarity between the date tree and the believer in this narration, but from a different, through a different chain, which is through Al-Harith ibn Abi Usama, rahmatullahi alayhi. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just like the date palm tree does not lose its leaves, the believer does not lose when he supplicates. Ibn Hajar said, just like it always benefits from its leaves, the believer always benefits from his dua, from his supplication. And this is supported by a hadith that is mentioned or reported by Al-Imam Ahmad and classed as authentic by Sheikh Al-Albani, narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما من مسلم يدعو بدعوة. Never does a Muslim supplicate with a dua ليس فيه إثم ولا قطيعة رحم, which does not include anything sinful or leads to severing ties with kinship, إلا كان له إحدى ثلاث, except that Allah Azza wa Jal will grant him for this supplication one of the following three. Number one, Allah will respond. So He will grant you and me what we're asking for. Oh Allah, cure my wife, so He cures me. Oh Allah, make my children successful, so He does. Oh Allah, lift this hardship off me, so He does. So He responds to the dua. That's number one. Number two, He reserves it for you until the day of judgment. أَوْ يَدَّخِرُهَا لَكُمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ. He keeps it for you and will pay it off in the form of good deeds. Reward, rather, not good deeds, in the form of reward. Right? The third is that Allah Azza wa Jal will protect the one supplicating from a harm that's equivalent to what he's asking for. Now number two and number three are things that are non-tangible. We can't see them and we can't feel them, right? Who knows what's going to happen on the Day of Judgment? And he who knows what is the evil that Allah protected him or her from as a result of this supplication which Allah did not grant him. Oh Allah, cure my wife. He doesn't, but He protects him from something more evil, more harmful, more stressful. Right? So the believer does not lose out. He always benefits from his dua. And this is another form the Prophet ﷺ gave from the similarity between the palm tree and the believer. The last point I want to address today, and we will continue in the series inshallah, is the description of the date tree as being طيبه, good, or it's also translated as pure. There's something good about the palm tree, but it's not limited to its fruits or its benefit, or its looks. No, it's comprehensive. It's all in totality good. And this is the case of the Muslim, of a believer. He is good. He is pure. And this purity is what is going to lead him or her to enter Jannah. Where is this coming from? It's coming from the saying of Allah. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. And those who feared the Lord will be driven to Jannah in groups until they come, they reach it. Whilst its gates are open, the keepers, the angels, will say, Salamun alaykum. We ask Allah to make us amongst them. Allahumma. Salamun alaykum. Peace. No more anxiety and fear. Halas. This is the end. You're starting the eternal bliss, the eternal life with which there is no worry, no sadness. Nothing but joy and happiness. Salamun alaykum. They're greeting them to enter Tibitum. You were good. You were pure by adhering to your Lord. You were good by refraining from what He prohibited. You were good by maintaining the garment of piety. فَدْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. So enter it and abide therein eternally. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to be amongst those who will be called by the angels saying, Salamun alaykum, tibitum fadkhuluha khalideen. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma a'izza al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma a'izza al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma a'izza al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. اللهم خذ أعداء الدين اللهم دمر أعداء الدين اللهم دمر أعداء الدين اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت اللهم عافنا فيمن عافيت اللهم تولنا فيمن توليت اللهم زين لنا أمورنا وطهر لنا قلوبنا ويسر لنا دروبنا اللهم آمين اللهم احفظنا قائمين واحفظنا قاعدين واحفظنا فوق التراب وتحت التراب ويوم الحساب يوم الدين اللهم آمين اللهم عليك بالطغاة المتجبرين اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في كل مكان اللهم انصر من كان في نصره عزة للإسلام والمسلمين ودمر من كان في دماره عزة للإسلام والمسلمين اللهم عليك بكل غاصب معتد أثيم اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين اللهم ارحمنا يوم الدين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات وآخر دعوانا